Hey everyone, Drew from Monkeys Tropicals Adventures here to do another fragrance review on
What Smells Good to Me?
So what are we going to talk about? So the fragrance we're going to talk about was sent to me, however I am going to give you a 100% honest review. With that being said, let's get on with it. So today we're going to talk about a hybrid creation by Alexander Fragrances called Game Time. So I'm sure a lot of you in the fragrance community, or maybe if you're new to the fragrance community, you're not aware, the big thing right now is combining two big powerhouse type fragrances and creating these beautiful accords, this beautiful fragrance by combination of beautiful scents. So that's what we have here. We have two powerhouse, two titans making one beautiful fragrance. Now this has been going on for quite a while. If you're a big fan of like Jo Malone or Bond No. 9, you know that they're about fragrance layering. And fragrance layering is really nice because you can capture some beautiful notes, amplify them, or really add some new beautiful notes in there. And as they morph and dry down, you create this just magnificent fragrance. So I think the fragrances that we're combining here are really, really beautiful. So much, in fact, that some people are probably tired of hearing about them. So what are they? Aventus, of course. And the other one is Baccarat Rouge 540. So what Game Time has done is it's combined the two beautiful fragrances from Creed and MFK and made this just really, really nice, smooth, sexy fragrance. So it is. It's a warm, spicy, sweet, citrus-type fragrance. And I'm going to tell you what I got from it. So I don't own Baccarat Rouge 540. I do, however, own several decants of Aventus. The one I'm comparing it today is 13W01. I've got about a bottle and a half worth of decants. This is more of a fruitier batch of Aventus, but let's kind of just go through the fragrances in itself. So Aventus is known really for its bergamot, blackcurrant, apple, pineapple, birch, ambergris, and vanilla. Where you got BR540, which is known for its jasmine, saffron, cedarwood, and ambergris. So like I said, I don't own BR540. However, I've done a lot of research on it, and I have a couple other inspired creations of BR540, and they're all pretty much in line with each other, which makes me kind of think that they've been able to capture the essence, the DNA, or maybe right on the money, I'm not sure, but they are all very good smelling fragrances. What I get from the BR540 in itself and some of my inspired fragrances is I get a really nice cotton candy vibe. Not overly sweet, but if you've ever smelled cotton candy when it's first made, that warm spun sugar is just a really, really beautiful scent. It's out of this world. And so that's what I kind of get when I spray the Game Time, is I get some of that warm spun sugar mixed with some really nice like black currant, birch, and pineapple notes. And as it starts to dry down, it gets really seductive and sexy and smooth, and it just turns into this really beautiful fragrance. So the hybrid of these two, the BR540 and the Aventus, is really captured in my opinion, and I, like I said, I can only speak to the Aventus because I have the Aventus, but what you get is just a really nice new fragrance that's not out there. So I'm just gonna spray and just tell you again my initial reaction when I spray the Game Time. Beautiful atomizer, comes out great. Okay, like I said, it's more out the initial spray, it's more Aventus dominated. I get a lot more of the birch and the pineapple, but I am getting some of those florals like the jasmine that you would find in BR540. And I'm getting, as it's starting to dry, now I'm not going off this because I just sprayed it, obviously dry, but I'm going as I was wearing it and it was drying down, I was getting more of that warm kind of spun cotton candy type smell. And as it went on, it just became this really nice fragrance that I would kind of get little wafts here and there. So the longevity was about 7-ish hours, maybe a little bit, give or take. Actually, it was longer than that because I had sprayed it on a sweatshirt because I did some ongoing testing with this over the last week and a half since I've had it. And it was just really, really nice still the next day. I think the dry down is really where it's at. Where do I see you wearing this fragrance? Because the fragrance is so, it's not overly light, but it's light as in you can wear it year round. I don't think you're gonna have any trouble in some heat with it. I would say a year round fragrance, and you can dress it up and dress it down. But this is a very sexy, smooth fragrance. So great date night fragrance, special occasion fragrance, a very nice office scent fragrance. Having some trouble with some words today. It captures two really great fragrances that on their own would be great for those environments. So you combine the two and you've just got some badass Battle House fragrances. So let's look at the comparison in price. If you were to buy the real thing and then make your own blend of spraying them and layering them, you're looking at $435 for a 100 ml Aventus bottle or $325 for a 50 ml, right? For a BR540 for a 70 ml, you're looking at $300. For this bottle, this is a 30 ml by Alexandria, you're looking at $42.99, or you can get a 55 ml for $62.99. So a disparaging difference between the two. And like I said, Alexandria has proven themselves to make some really great fragrances that are either right on the money or come pretty damn close to creating the real thing. Their original creations are out of this world as well. What I ask is that you go explore the Alexandria page and look at all the different fragrances. Get yourself some of those six decants that look like this, or get some of those travel atomizers of the ones you really like, perfect for travel, it's a little bit larger size, or pick yourself up a bottle. The nice thing Alexandria does is they do these sales all the time, like 20% off, 25 up to 30 sometimes. And you, if you sign up for their email notifications or you follow them on Instagram, you'll find out when either a new fragrance is dropping or when they're doing one of these sales. So it's really worth you doing that. It doesn't take much time at all, just like it doesn't take any time for you to like and subscribe this video. So make sure you follow Alexandria. Follow me over on Instagram at Monkeys Tropicals Adventures. Go and leave your comment below some Alexandria fragrances that you've tried, or maybe some layering techniques that you've done with some fragrances. Let me know some fragrances from Alexandria you'd like me to see review in the future, and I'll see you again for another fragrance review. Take care.